In today's BookPill episode, we will dive deep into Richard Dawkins's The Selfish Gene and explore how does the idea of our bodies being mere survival machines for our genes challenge traditional views of individuality and human purpose? In what surprising ways could seemingly selfless acts serve as clever survival strategies for our selfish genes? Given that mutation is often seen negatively, how can it actually act as a driving force behind evolutionary innovation? Stay tuned to discover, learn, and reflect on these intriguing aspects of evolution. Welcome to BookPill, where we serve up literary vitamins faster than you can eat an apple. Today we're diving into The Selfish Gene by renowned author Richard Dawkins, a mind-bending tome that posits a fresh perspective on evolution, suggesting that genes, not species, are the real catalysts driving the survival of the fittest. Dawkins artfully employs an array of biological case studies, computer simulations, and thought experiments to bolster the provocative argument that genes are the puppeteers manipulating life forms to secure their survival. While acknowledging some critics who argue for group or species-level selection, Dawkins maintains that these theories fall short of gene-centric explanations. He leaves us with an intriguing idea. If genes are the architects of life, we, their creations, have, paradoxically, become capable of shaping our genetic future, progressed far from the unwitting puppets we once were. So, fellow bookworms, here's to finding clarity in life's complexity, one gene at a time. This is 10 most important lessons from the book Richard Dawkins, The Selfish Gene. Picture this. In the world of genetics, it's not simply the strongest or most adaptable organisms that secure the future. The ones that tend to have a winning edge are often those carrying the most selfish genes. Now, when we say selfish, we're not suggesting they're mean or unkind. Rather, it's about those genes that are best at ensuring their own propagation, even if it's sometimes at the expense of the very organism they inhabit. It's a fascinating twist on traditional survival tactics, isn't it? Now let's take a moment to reflect on ourselves. Evolution shows us a different perspective of our existence. We're essentially survival machines, natural vessels with one underlying purpose: to pass our genes on to the next generation. You might feel like you're the one calling all the shots, but from a biological viewpoint, most of what we do is subtly orchestrated by our genes, keen on securing their journey forward in time. It's an intriguing, humbling idea, putting into perspective our place in time and nature, don't you think? Think about the idea of being kind and caring for a moment. Altruism, acting in the interest of others, might initially seem to contradict the idea of selfish genes. But here's the thing, it doesn't. Quite the opposite, in fact. Acts of kindness can strategically ensure the survival of our genes by promoting a society in which we, and thus our genes, are more likely to thrive. So, in a strange twist of fate, being selfish can at times mean being selfless too. Fascinating, isn't it? Look around at the breathtaking variety of life on our planet. We're constantly amazed by the dizzying array of colors, behaviors, and adaptations we see in nature. Yet, zoom down at the genetic level, and it all boils down to one simple motive: the continuation of selfish genes. It's a stunning revelation, where life's mind-boggling complexity and variation suddenly appears as an orchestrated masterpiece of genetic survival strategy. Consider that timeless argument we've all pondered: nature versus nurture. Genetic influence or environmental shaping, which has the most dominant role in creating who we are? The concept of selfish genes introduces a compelling perspective into this debate, highlighting the complex interplay between our inherited genetic code and our environmental experiences. It's like a twofold dance, with our genes dictating the rhythm, yet the social milieu crafting the choreography. Have you ever wondered why we, as social creatures, behave the way we do? Even actions that appear selfless can contribute to the gene's ultimate goal of ensuring its own survival. Sharing, caring, and reciprocal acts create a cooperative environment where genes have a better overall chance to thrive. So next time you extend a helping hand, remember that more than kindness might be at play, your genes might be thanking you for boosting their survival odds. While our genes may set the stage, it turns out that culture and societal pressure also hold leading roles in the magnificent drama we call life. It's like an endless dance-off, our genes strutting their moves while society adjusts the rhythm and pace. This interaction shapes our behaviors in ways that aren't always straightforwardly genetic. So, while our genes undoubtedly dictate the show, the influence of our environment creates a truly dynamic and unexpected performance. From the snow leopard's camouflage to the monarch butterfly's mimicry, it's clear nature is a grand stage for diversity. This doesn't happen randomly. Instead, the major players behind the scenes are our ever-selfish genes. Fiercely competing for a starring role in the next generation, they engage in a sort of combat dance. This relentless competition fuels the evolutionary process, giving rise to the dazzling differences we cherish in our natural world. You might have heard the term mutation and thought, that can't be good. But hold on, it's time for a rethink. Mutations, changes in the gene's code, are often the wild cards that deliver evolutionary leaps. They can introduce new traits that provide survival advantages, ultimately fueling the engine of life's innovation and diversity. So next time you hear about a mutation, remember, it could be nature's way of mixing things up for the better. While we've often considered survival to be a tale of triumphant species, there's a different and perhaps more riveting story unfolding beneath the surface. The relentless drive of genes to carry on, often described as their selfishness, forms a majestic narrative of life's history. Each gene plots its own survival, in turn shaping the traits of the creatures that carry them. So, who's the genuine hero of our evolutionary tale, species or genes? It seems the latter might be stealing the show. Unlocking the selfish gene's secrets isn't just about understanding our DNA. It's about peering into the very essence of life itself. Dawkins, with his uncanny knack for clarity cloaked in complexity, imparts transformative insights. In the delicate dance of survival, we're not just organisms, we're DNA propagating survival machines. If you relished this ride through the poignant poetry and prosaic precision of genetics, don't be stingy. Share the knowledge, click like, hit subscribe, and join our BookPill community. After all, we're all about that selfish share. Till next time, remember, the book of life may have no real final chapter, but at BookPill, there's always another page to turn.